Hey guys, welcome to this lecture on embedded C programming. Today let us talk about some other concepts of embedded C programming.
So for more such videos, do subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon so that you will never miss the video, and do follow us on Instagram. And if you haven't watched the previous video, do watch that video. Link is in the I button.
Data types and variables that we are going to use in embedded C programming. First of all, here's a program already written, like include stdio.h in main and printf, size of the data type int is equal to suppressant d size of char. This is just a pulled program. Let me delete this. What are the different data types that people generally use to write their C program? So the data types are that people uses are char, and then int, and then short int, and then long int, and then long int, and others, right? So let us talk about these data types that people generally uses for embedded C programming. If we talk about char data type, right? So char data type generally takes character types of data, like if my name is XYZ, then those XYZ values will be stored in char data type. Char data type over here takes only one byte of data in the memory architecture. Let me write here like one byte of data. And if we talk about short int, so short int is gonna take 2 bytes of data. So if we talk about int, then int is gonna take 4 bytes of data in ARM microcontrollers, and long int is gonna take 8 bytes, and long int is also gonna take 8 bytes of space in memory architecture. So hope you people can see these values. So I have written that char data type is going to take only 1 byte of data, or the 1 byte of memory in the memory architecture. So you people know that 1 byte is equals to 8 bit. Generally 8 bits are going to store for every character types of data, right? If we are going to store char data type, so we are going to get only 1 byte of data. And similar with the int data type, we are going to get 4 bytes. For short int, we are going to get 2 bytes, which is equals to 16 bit, and 4 bytes is equals to 32 bit, right? And long int is going to give us 64 bits of data in the memory architecture. So that's a huge big value, right? These data types can be signed or unsigned. Like if the value is plus or minus, like if I'm using char, it can be unsigned char also. Right, if I have written unsigned, that means that knows that it is always positive value, not an odd. It can be any value, it is never signed value, right? It is not plus and not minus. So similarly, I can use signed over here. There's nothing like to be written like signed. So it is automatically understood by the compiler that if I am writing int, so it is automatically signed. If I have to specify the unsigned also, I'll write like this unsigned int. And similarly, all of the data types can be written like unsigned and signed. This totally depends on you if you want to use the unsigned data type or not. Other thing that we are going to talk about, the variables, like the variables that people generally uses to store a value. How we are going to define a variable? What are the things that we are going to add to define a variable? Like if my variable only takes integer types of data, 1 to 100 or 1 to any value. So what we are going to do is we are going to write int my variable name. Okay, let me generalize this statement of definition. Statement of definition gives us that first of all, data type will come, and then my variable name will come, right? This is actually a variable definition, right? So we are giving a definition over here. So this is actually a variable definition. What we are going to do is we are going to write the data type and then the variable. So like for example, if I write data type as int, and variable name can be anything like XYZ. So it can be anything, just terminate it. So this is my variable definition. Now there is another thing, that is variable initialization. So how I do variable initialization? So I am gonna give int, let us take abc is equals to 100. So now what I have done here is I have defined a variable and also initialized a variable in a single line. Or I can also do like this also, like if I define variable up and then abc is equals to 100. So this is also a nice way of doing variable initializations and definition. So the first line over here is variable definition and the second line over here is variable initialization. So now whenever in this, in the int main function, I'll call abc, it automatically will give the value 100. Let us see an example. If I write int abc and abc is equals to 100, then let me print it, right? So printf value of variable is equals to %d. Okay, so why I have written %d over here? So actually %d is a format specifier for int type data types, right? Int types of data type. You people might be thinking that so what we are going to use for char and other kinds of data type. So for char you are going to use %c for the character type data types, right? If your data is unsigned, then you are going to use %u, right? So there are different format specifiers that we are going to see in the coming videos. So that's not a big deal. We'll be seeing different kinds of data types and their format specifiers. So for int, we are going to use %d. Now, after this, I have to give a comma and give the value abc or give the variable name and terminate it. Okay, so now let us build this program. Okay, so here we can see that we have no error and no warning. And now let us run this program. Okay, so now my value is equals to 100. You can see over here that value of variable is equals to 100. So this is, and this scale clearly show you that how people uses variables and data types. So this is a basic thing that people generally use in their C programming. Now see one more thing, that if we are gonna print the hex value of 100, like if we want the hexadecimal value of this value 100, so we are gonna use format specifier %x, and then we are gonna run this program and we are gonna see the hex value coming over here, that is 64. So hex value of 100 is 64. If we are going to present this %x, then that means that our value is 64, right? These were the things that I want to show you. In the next lecture, we'll see about float types of data types and how we are going to use these float variables.
So I hope you find this video informative and useful. To see you in the next video. Till then, take care.